Hello everybody, this is Seether Court here, and welcome to the newest episode of Seether Talks. Today's topic is going to be on something that is not really that relevant anymore, and most people who have brought this up in the past were from a little over a year ago, because that's when this whole discussion was relevant. I decided that it's okay for me to discuss this for a video because I usually am someone who is always late to the party when it comes to discussing what's relevant and all. Today's video is going to focus on a certain product that has been available to the fandom for quite a while, and it has been provided by the company known as Walmart. This product has been seen as kind of the center of controversy within the fandom due to many of us members deeming it as low quality and cringeworthy. And that item that I've been building up for this video is what is known as Maskimals, or what many others in the fandom refer to it as, Walmart fursuits. To give a little explanation as to what these Maskimals are, they are soft costume masks that you can purchase for around $20 at Walmart. And they mostly depict animals, but there are also a few that depict certain cartoon animals. Two in particular that I found were of Rocco from Rocco's Modern Life, and Chucky from Rugrats. I am pretty sure that Walmart did start selling these with furries in mind due to these being released around the time where the furry fandom was at its highest form of society recognition. So it would make sense for Walmart to want to make a quick buck off of these to cash in on the furry market, if that makes any sense. These masks have been provided with both good and bad reception from people within the furry fandom. The good coming from particularly younger people within the fandom, believing that this is a nice, cheap, and safe way for young furries to have this easy way to experience the awesomeness of fursuiting to an extent. The bad of this is coming from more older people within the fandom, feeling that these suits are very cheap, ugly, and unprofessionally made, to where they feel that this can give off a negative image of the fandom if more and more people start buying these suits rather than buying actually commissioned fursuits that are of high quality. Let's now get into my personal opinions about the whole Maskimal craze, since I have now covered pretty much the general opinions of everyone else on this item. When it comes to the actual items themselves, I personally do not like them. They look like they are obviously very cheap and low quality. They are ugly and overall not a pleasant sight to see, and the $20 price tag for them makes a lot of sense due to the very low quality materials they use to make them. These masks look like something a non-furry would buy to wear one time for a Halloween party and then never wear it again. I personally would never buy one myself, but if I had a kid then maybe I would get them one just to go trick-or-treating in if they really wanted it. When it comes to the positives that younger furries are giving to these masks, I think that it's great and I'm glad that they have a way of experiencing fursuiting on a smaller scale without having to worry about investing too much money into getting one at such a young age, and also risking accidentally outgrowing a full suit that they commission once they get older. So overall, this is a good product for a young furry to kind of preoccupy their time until they get older to commission an actual fursuit. When it comes to the negatives that the older furries are giving these masks, I'd say that I do agree that these are very low quality and all. But when it comes to them being an embarrassment to the furry fandom, I'd have to disagree. The reason that I say this is because the majority of people who are buying these are the young furries, and for the most part this is really the only chance they'll get for a while at fursuiting because they're too young to get a job to work up towards buying a fursuit. I want to bring up for a quick second a video that I made a year ago entitled Little Girl Harassed at BLFC, a previous episode of Seether Talks I did, which I must add that this is the most successful video on my entire channel with over 70,000 views. Thank you all so much for that. In the video, I discussed how last year at Biggest Little FurCon, there was a little girl who got harassed at the convention by two full-grown men because she was wearing one of these Maskimals. It was definitely a very disgusting thing to hear about, and it made me feel so bad for this girl and all the other young furries out there who have to get made fun of for owning these. So overall, if you are an older furry within this fandom, please, please, please don't harass these kids for these masks because there is nothing morally wrong with owning slash wearing one of them, and also know that they are just kids at the end of the day, so you shouldn't expect them to wear a legitimate fursuit yet, which are designed to be for older furries, who do have their own form of financial income that can commission them themselves. And that pretty much overall wraps up my thoughts about Maskimals or the Walmart fursuits and this episode of Seether Talks altogether. How do you guys feel about Maskimals or the Walmart fursuits as they put it? Do you guys like them? Do you guys hate them? Do you think they're okay for the furry fandom? Do you feel like they're not a good thing for the furry fandom? Let me know down in the comment section down below. If you enjoy my content and want to further help out my channel, please consider donating to my Patreon page and my Ko-fi, hitting that like button, turning on that notification bell, and subscribing altogether. I've been Seether Court, and I will see you guys in the next video. Goodbye, everyone.
Mama Toyo.
Sexy goat mom, everybody.
I don't know why people draw her with boobs and she clearly has none.
Are you judging her for being a flat-chested individual?
She's a monster. We don't know her anatomy. She's
female boobs and shit.
Does she